I can start this off and then I'll have some friends come in with me. So how I'm, there's obviously multiple ways to do this, but the way that I'm going to choose is a hybrid, essentially a hybrid of our net and just a regular straight string system.
Okay.
So I'm going to be doing kind of a more simple, probably more structured version of a Florida weave. If you guys ever heard of Florida weave, you just kind of go crazy, make a web over your trellising, and then they climb right up, which is a great system. I would recommend it. I think we can get away with saving a little more on our string. Personally, I like to save my string as much as possible, and so I tie it in such a way that I can untie it in little loop knots. That's a personal preference for you guys if you'd like. So I start mine off. I start off just tall enough to where the plants can touch, but not too tall to where they're really reaching and then start to fall over, right? So we want to make it about to right here. I want to do as little training as possible. I don't want to have to come back and maintenance things. In the past, we've done that tomato system, but we've used jute and hemp string in an effort to be more sustainable, right? We love it. However, over the summer rains, raining, and then the weight of the actual plant with the fruit on it, it would fall. And I was like, I'm not doing tomatoes ever again. Having to go back and trellis those systems, going back to update systems is a part of the process, right? But when I could have made maybe a more functional decision, right? So this one, I wasn't paying attention, I'm going to loop it. So again, I'm going to loop it. I go above and under for strength. Like that. So we go around a couple times, making it nice and strong. Continue on my space. Now it's when I go back across is when I start to switch up. Do one of two things. This is just personal preference. No, straight. Okay. So I've got it locked. So I'm going to choose to not cut it right here. I want to keep it long. I could either go ahead and just do my next section about 8 inches, maybe 6 to 8 inches above this next one, and so I will have horizontal lines going up, right? What I'm going to do, because I understand the growing pattern of these particular quirky bits, I'm actually going to go across, but at a diagonal. See right here, this is where my old one was. I'm going up like this. And so you see I'm creating this angle up here. It was funny, Henry was doing this yesterday at our farm, and then he stopped because he wasn't sure if this was what we were going to do. And I was like, this is great, this is it. Okay.